Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nijjar, a retired lecturer in metallurgy preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here I render an exposition of the Gospel of Infancy, Arabic. The Arabic Gospel of the Infancy of the Savior, Christ Jesus, translated by Alexander Roberts and James Donaldson, from pages 404 to 415 of volume 8 of the Ante-Nicene Fathers. Notes by A. Cleveland Cox. So this is written by the book people, you know, they are not Gnostic who wrote these things, translation. So they are using the word Lord quite often. Lord is Christ. Jesus was not Lord. He was our brother, anointed brother, and he was super servant. So if we call Christ Jesus a Lord, then as you know, the Pope became Lord over the people in the name of Christ Jesus, because they were sitting in the name of Christ Jesus. So they start lording over people instead of serving and killing and burning people. So Christ Jesus is our anointed elder brother, but not a Lord. The word Lord does not appear in the kingdom of royal kingdom of God, because God is sets you free. God is spirit. He is not Lord. And so is the Son. Christ Jesus is not our Lord. We get attracted to Father and Son because of their attributes. And so we have philo, love of philo, philosophical love that we show to them, and that's the bond between us and our brother and our Father, God. However, in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, one God. So this is, you know, the common the proclamation of these once born people of the book. With the help and favor of the Most High, we begin to write a book of the miracles of our anointed elder brother Christ Jesus, and not the Lord, but the super servant and brother, and not Master and Savior Jesus, the Christ, which is called the Gospel of Infancy, in the peace of our Father, and not the Lord. Amen. We find what follows in the book of Joseph, the high priest, who lived in the time of Christ. Some say he is Caiaphas. He has said that Jesus spoke, and indeed, when he was lying in his cradle, said to Mary, his mother. Mary was not his mother, but Mary was anointed a woman, special woman. The mother of Christ Jesus was Holy Spirit, which is our mother also. I am Jesus, the Son of God, the Logos, whom thou hast brought forth, as the angels Gabriel announced to thee. And my Father has sent me for the salvation of the world. Remember, John said, you know, in the beginning was the Word, and Word became flesh in the name of Jesus. In the 309th year of the era of Alexander, Augustus put forth an edict that every man should be enrolled in his native place. Joseph therefore arose, and taking Mary, his spouse, went away to Jerusalem, and came to Bethlehem to be enrolled along with his family in his native city. So King David belonged to Bethlehem, and so this Joseph, because Christ Jesus was to be born in the line of King David. But as the people had become unfaithful to Abraham, so he had to take a virgin birth. I've explained the virgin birth of Christ Jesus in my videos and articles, so you can read them. And having come to a cave, Mary told Joseph that the time of the birth was at hand, and that she could not go into the city, but said, "She, let us go into this cave." Now some say it was a cave, the others say it was an inn. So inn gave you a little bit better analogy, because inn is representative of the church of God, where everyone is welcome. So is into the inn. Inn is analogous to the church of God, and the highest in the church of God is the lowest. That means our brother Christ Jesus, being the highest, he should be born at the lowest place, which was the manger of an in the inn, where the serving animal rest. So he came among his own type. And Joseph went out in haste to go for a woman to be near her. And when therefore he was busy about that, he saw an Hebrew old woman belonging to Jerusalem, and said, "Come hither, my good woman, and go into this cave, in which there is a woman near her time. Wherefore, after sunset, the old woman and Joseph with her came to the cave, and they both went in, and behold, it was filled with lights more beautiful than the gleaming of lamps and candles." You know, the sunshine has its own beauty than the lamps. Lamps were Moses. Lamps and candle belong to Moses, and sun belong to Christ Jesus. And more splendid than the lights of the sun. The child enwrapped in swaddling clothes was sucking the breast of the Lady Mary, his woman, not the mother, being placed in a stall. And when both were wondering at this light, the old woman asked the Lady Mary, "Art thou the mother of this child?" And when the Lady Mary gave her assent, she says, "Thou art not at all like the daughters of Eve." Daughters of Eve are not like a common woman. The Lady Mary said, "As my son has no equal among children, so his mother has no equal among women." So it should be mother, you remember, was the Holy Spirit, and Mary was just a woman to Christ Jesus. Woman that brought forth the Logos in the name of Jesus. The old woman replied, "My mistress, I came to get payment. I have been for a long time affected with palsy." Our mistress, the Lady Mary, said to her, "Place thy hand upon the child." And the old woman did so and was immediately cured. Then she went forth, saying, "Henceforth I will be attendant and servant of this child all the days of my life." Then came shepherds and when they had lighted a fire and were rejoicing greatly, there appeared to them the hosts of heaven, praising and celebrating God Most High. And while the shepherds were doing the same, the cave was at that time made like a temple of the upper world, since both heavenly and earthly voices glorified and magnified God on account of the birth of our brother Christ Jesus, and not the Lord Jesus Christ. So, God bless you. Thank you.